Hi everyone. Today we will talk about how to call Android promise and callback function from React Native. And so firstly, in Android project, we can create a callback function here. So the callback function is a function that has the value returned after a period of time, and in this time, you can do somewhere else. And we have a function named do callback task, and we have a parameter, a number is integer or a double and a string. And we have two callback one callback for success and one callback for false. So inside this we have a try-cat block. So the try-cat block will return to do something and return to fail or success callback result. If it has error, for example, we true the error if we have a number is equal to 100 and the error here is an exception. So the exception here is a super class that return to any exception, and the exception here is input number is 100 and cannot do this task, for example. And if it is success, you can return the result as some of the field like name, email, address, etc., and age. So to return a various type of value, you can use a hash table map or an argument or an, some separated arguments. Okay, so in this line, you can call success callback, and the success callback will invoke. Invoke here means that the result callback function has three parameters, name, email, and age, etc. And we have three parameter, one for e. And when it is full, it will invoke the arrow like a message by calling e dot get message to return a string of message. And it is here React method annotation. You can add the annotation here. So in React Native, you can call the callback function here. So the callback function here in this case, you call is in toast module and function name. And the first parameter is the number, and the number is integer value. And the second here is the successful callback, or the callback for success case. For the success case, we have three parameter: name, email, and age. It's very easy to understand. If you have many arguments or parameters here, you can add it into inside a map, a mutable map. Yes, and the callback for false. What is the case for microphone? You can call the cell text with the string. The string here is error is equal to error message to print out the error message with a long periods of time by calling toast module dot len long. Yes. So in terminal, you call the React Native run Android, wait a few seconds to build to your device and see. Okay, and reload. So press to React Native call. Yes, you can see that we can show the value for successful. In this case, we show detail about name, age, and email address. Okay, so you can have many parameter as you like. So reload by Ctrl M and reload the program and press. Okay, so we have the result name as Huang, email address. Okay, yes, it's quite easy in your project. You can change 100 for error. In this case, you can see it will show the error because it is 100. Yes, and reload. So press here. So input parameter is number can cannot do this task. Okay, and we have two case. So the function to callback task is a callback function, and we also have another case to use a promise or async await. So the promise here can compatible or can be used in a single wait function. So we have a function here do promise task, and the top promise task has parameter number, and number is integer, and the promise, the promise object here, and inside this block we have try catch. Yes, the try and catch here, we have a map. The result is a writable map. A writable map is a map like key value, as in the object of JavaScript or hash table map. Then you can set various type of value to here, like set name as a value, email as a value, for example. And we also set the value for integer by put in, and for the property age is about 40, and you resolve means success, and reject mean error. Okay, so in catch exception, you can call the reject function by promise.reject with the reason. The reason is a string, and the detail is arrow, and the exception object. So in React Native, you can use to call the async and await by try get using async await. But when you use async await, you have to use the asynchronous function, because await is only put in an async function. So the function on press button is an asynchronous function. And you can call the do promise task with the input parameter 11. And here's a number, and the promise is a result, and the result here. After finish result, you can come to next line with showing text by Lession stringify to convert the result to string to show in the screen. And otherwise, you send the arrow by show text arrow and the arrow object for a long period of time. So it is here, and when you run, you have to quit the previous program and run again, run Android, React Native, run Android, and wait a few seconds to see the output. So reload the program again. You can press reload and press Android React Native code toast. Okay, so in this case, you can see that it is a result as you expected. But in the error case, the promise will be rejected. And you can check for if number is equal to 100, you can throw an exception. Yes, I had 100. Okay, so in this case, the function is false, and rerun the program again, React Native, run Android, and see the result. And when you press to an iron cone toast, you can see that error. And the detail error auto reason is I had 100. Okay, so this is the end of my lesson today about how to clone Java's function in React Native using callback and promise or async await. Thank you so much for watching.